What's up everyone, Eber here with hardwarecanucks, and we're still here at CES 2019. Mike just passed by me if you didn't notice, probably you might not notice. But anyways, we're still here at the show trying to bring you the best content or more content from the show floor. But I wanted to talk about Corsair's new Slipstream wireless technology and what and why it's super important for the future of gaming peripherals like keyboards, mice and headsets. So let's get started. But first, huge shout out to our sponsors, Corsair, Phanteks, Razer, MSI, and Thermaltake, because without them, this trip really would not have been possible. Now, a few days ago, we posted a video about Corsair's new mice for 2019, and if you're interested in checking that out, link is right over here. But essentially, we did talk a little bit about Slipstream technology, but we didn't really get too much into it. And the reason is because we didn't have any information about the new tech. But after having a one-on-one session with Corsair, we have a lot, actually there's a lot to be excited about this new technology. And the fact that it's actually shipping on a $50 mouse like the Harpoon Wireless is pretty amazing. Now the intent for Slipstream is to provide improvements for how wireless communications are handled. With it, response times should decrease, ranges will get boosted, and there should be less issues in areas with high wireless traffic. Basically, what Slipstream does is use the 2.4 GHz spectrum, but with a proprietary protocol that's been developed by Corsair. That protocol allows supporting peripherals to handle twice the number of wireless packets within a millisecond. There's also intelligent frequency shift, which actively scans the wireless spectrum to find the best transmit frequency. So that's a lot of technical stuff to digest, but what does that really mean for gamers? Well, on a mouse like the Harpoon Wireless, you're gonna get sub 1 millisecond response times, but supposedly you're also expected to get about up to 60 hours of battery life with just a single charge, and you could also use this mouse 60 feet away from the actual receiver. And I'm kind of starting to wonder, why would you even use that feature? I mean, for HTPC setups, sure, but 60 feet away is just like, I mean, it's cool tech, but I wanna know your thoughts on that particular, you know, feature in the comments down below. Basically, the Harpoon Wireless is the first in the lineup of upcoming peripherals that will have Slipstream technology, but Corsair said that the biggest potential for it will be within wireless headsets. The problem with current wireless headsets is that they do typically lack range, and in some cases they do encounter interferences, and the microphone quality is just not that great, and we've encountered them or experienced them with previous wireless headset reviews. Now, Slipstream basically eliminates all of these issues by basically providing a high bandwidth connection that allows for downstream, a high definition, a game audio, as well as lossless upstream voice communication at the same time. That's just not possible with today's current wireless standards. Another interesting thing that Corsair mentioned is range on these headsets could be around 100 feet, which is pretty amazing. And the last thing that I wanted to mention about Slipstream is that up to 4 devices can run off a single USB controller, which is actually pretty awesome because considering laptops are slowly starting to get rid of, you know, full-size Type-A ports and just getting, you know, a few ports, this is a great way to, you know, be able to connect your wireless headset, your peripherals, your other peripherals, and just control them via a single USB receiver. The other thing that I wanted to discuss quickly is Corsair's CapEx LEDs, because they could be a game changer in many ways. Traditional LEDs are mounted to a large surface and then they are separate controllers that require space. Corsair is now mounting their LEDs directly to the PCB, which increases density, brightness, and overall efficiency. This is a quick example showing the space necessary to mount 132 CapEx RGB LEDs versus a traditional RGB strip. It's just really amazing to see this kind of technology miniaturizing. In terms of what it means for products, well, there's a couple ways to look at CapEx. Because of its lower power consumption, peripherals with the technology will provide much better battery life, heat output will also be lower, so incorporating them into things like memory and motherboards will come with less trade-offs as well. Corsair was also showing off their first CapEx product with the Dominator Platinum RGB. It uses 12 individually addressable LEDs per module for some crazy looking lighting effects. And remember, this is just where Corsair is starting, so it'll be interesting to see where they go from here. So there you guys have it. It's really awesome to see a company like Corsair taking things differently with, you know, something like Slipstream technology, and of course, you know, a technology like CapEx with their RGB LED setup. But I'm looking forward to what they can come upon in the next or their upcoming products for 2019 and of course the years to come. But yeah, let me know what you guys think about the two new things that we discussed in this video in the comments down below. I'm Ivor with hardwarecanucks. Thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned for more CES 2019 coverage. Dimitri is right over there chilling with his AirPods and his iPhone XS. Michael is, he's just chilling with his Lenovo notebook. And we'll see you
in the next video.